you ever wanna bet on us, if you ever wanna be my one, I'll be waiting. If you ever want one more night, if you ever wanna make things right, if you ever wanna change your mind, I'll be waiting. I'll be waiting.
This is Radio 2, we're on your BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 6 o'clock, this is Harvey Cook. A judge has told a former Metropolitan Police officer convicted of multiple rapes and sexual assaults that he took monstrous advantage of women while he was serving with the force. David Carrick will spend a minimum of almost 31 years in prison for a total of 85 offences against a dozen women over 17 years. The Attorney General's office has said it's been contacted multiple times with concerns that the sentence was unduly lenient. Our correspondent Helena Wilkinson was in court for the hearing.
David Carrick sat in a glass dock here today for his sentencing hearing. Some of his victims sat around 5 metres away behind him, wanting to see the man who committed these offences and who caused them so much trauma, and still they go through that to see him being punished.
The Public and Commercial Services Union says around 100,000 civil servants will go on strike on Budget Day, the 15th of March, in what it describes as an escalation of its dispute with the government. The union says there's been a lack of movement on the issues of pay, pensions and job security. Turkey's President Erdogan has declared a state of emergency across a large part of the country as rescue efforts continue in the wake of yesterday's devastating earthquakes in Turkey and Syria. More than 5,000 people are now known to have died. The World Health Organization says freezing conditions are hampering the rescue. The WHO spokesperson Margaret Harris explained the scale of the disaster.
At least 23 million people are exposed to the effects of these earthquakes in both countries. And that's just a preliminary assessment. Many, many hospitals just do not have what they need to function, just simple things like power, like fuel. And of course, we don't know the numbers of health workers who've been affected.
A 45-year-old man's been found guilty of the manslaughter by gross negligence of his teenage daughter, who was morbidly obese when she died at the family home in Paris in October 2020. Alan Titford had said his partner was responsible for the care of Kaylee, who was 16 years old and weighed more than 22 stone. Her mother, Sarah Lloyd-Jones, has already admitted the same charge. Jonathan Rees from David Powers Police said it was an horrific case to work on.
The conditions in which Kaylee was found were abhorrent and indicated shocking neglect over a prolonged period of time, both environmentally and physically. The circumstances of Kaylee's death are tragic. This investigation has been extensive and at times harrowing, given Kaylee's age and the conditions in which she was living.
Spain's transport minister has apologised after her department commissioned 30 new trains which were too big for some of the country's tunnels. The mistake was apparently made because of an error in measuring. And the weather, variable amounts of cloud and the odd spot of rain across northern parts of the UK tonight. Clearer skies in the south with some patchy fog. That's the BBC News at 3 minutes past six.
Harvey, thank you very much.
When there's someone by your side to sing,
life's a happy song.
When there's someone by your side to sing,
life's a happy song. When there's someone by your side to sing.
We are by your side till 7 o'clock. Then Joe is here with a shiny happy playlist and James King reviews M. Night Shyamalan's latest film, Knock at the Cabin. I think he's based on Centre Parks, maybe, where love blossoms in the rapids. Tonight's NPD.
Hello, Sarah. My name's Abby and I'm from Oakworth in West Yorkshire. Tonight for my dinner, I am having chicken thighs marinated in tandoori spices with yogurt and mint dressing in a wrap, homemade wedges and homemade coleslaw. I cannot wait. Love your show.
Wow. I'm heading round to Abby's right now. Come on. Are we in it, team? Tomorrow on Breakfast, we're talking to Gemma Arterton about her new series, Funny Woman. Joins over from 6:30.